beautiful crochet lovers, I'm Susanna. Welcome to my channel. Today I would like to show you this pretty easy square pattern. This is like a, you know, zigzag pattern, but it's very beautiful in the center. And the outer has a, you know, large space that affects a beautiful square. I would like to change the color on the center and outer. So, and let's see how it works. Okay, and this is very easy and pretty, and you can enlarge as many rounds as you want, so please enjoy. Okay, let's get started. I would like to use this thickness yarn, but you can use any yarn. And for this yarn, I'm going to use size 6.5, but it's up to your preferences. Okay, first, you can make a magic link or chain full. I prefer chain full to make tight or, you know, a strong circle. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and into the first stitch. Make a link. So there is a little space here. So it's very small, tiny space. Alright, so let's start. Chain 3, count as a double, and yarn over. Insert into this tiny space, please make double crochet. Now, 2 double crochet. So please make 4 double crochet. Oh, excuse me. After making 4 double crochet, please make chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yarn over into the space, and then please make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3. Then please make chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and please repeat 4 double crochet and chain 5 and 4 double crochet. And before making last chain 5, I'm gonna show you how to finish this round. Alright, see you later. Alright, 4 double crochet, chain 5, 4 double crochet, chain 5, 4 double crochet, chain 5, and 4 double crochet. So let's finish this round. Please make chain 2 first, and then please make double crochet into third chain. 1, 2, 3 here. This is the first round. Move to second round. Start with chain 3, count as a double. And please make 3 more double crochets. So please make 4 double crochet in this space. One, two, three, four. Please make chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Move to the next space here, and please make 4 double crochet. 1, to sleep full. After making four double crochet, please make chain five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And back to the same space and please make four double crochet. So let's make a corner. After making a corner, please make chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and into the next corner, please make a 4 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, After making 4 double crochet, please make chain 5. And so let's make a corner back to the same space, make 4 double crochet. Okay, repeat like this. Okay, in the last corner, please make 4 double crochet. Then join with chain 2 and double crochet into the third chain. 1, 2, 3 here. This is the second round and move to the third round. Alright, move to the third round. So start with chain 3 and 3 double crochet. So please make 4 double crochet in chain 5 space. Four. Okay, after making 4 double crochet into the next chain 3 space here, and please make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4. After making 4 double crochet, please make chain 2. 1, 2. And back to the same space, please make 4 double crochet. Four double crochet, chain 2, and 4 double crochet. Then move to the corner and please make 4 double crochet, chain 5, and 4 double crochet. After making four double crochet, please make chain 5, 2, 3, 4, 5. And back to the same space. And please make four double crochet. Okay, and next chain 3 space, please make 4 double crochet and chain 2 and 4 double crochet again. So please repeat this. And the corner is 4 double crochet, chain 5, and 4 double crochet. And the center is 4 double crochet, chain 2, and 4 double crochet. And please repeat and see you at the end of this round. Alright, into the last space, please make 4 double crochet again. Then chain 2 and join with the double crochet into the third turning chain. 1, 2, 3, joining chain. So please make double crochet. And I would like to change the color, so chain 1 and fasten off the yarn. Okay, this is the first 3 rounds. And move, and the shape is like this. It is still very beautiful, isn't it? So you can join with other motifs endlessly, and then you can make a motif blankets or motif bags or whatever you can use as a motif, or you motif cardigan or motif sweater. Okay. All right. From now, I would like to show you how to continue this pattern. And this pattern is a repeating of second rounds and third rounds, as many rounds as you want. All right. Okay, let's move to round 4. Okay, let's continue. So let's please make a slip knot and join into the maybe the different corner and join with the single crochet. Then please make chain 2 count as a double and please make 4 double crochet including this joining single crochet and chain 2. After making first 4 double crochet corner, so this is repeating of round 2, please make chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and move to chain 2 space of these 4 double crochet clusters. So please make 4 double crochet After making 4 double crochet, please make chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and skip 4 double crochet and into the next chain 5 space, and please make 4 double crochet again and chain 5 and 4 double crochet corner. So please make a corner first. Okay, after making a corner, please repeat this side, remaining all sides, and please make corner as usual. Please make chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and into the chain 2 space of this triangle top, and please make 4 double crochet. And chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and move to the next space. Okay, see you later. Alright, finish the fourth row and move to the fifth row. Fifth row is repeat of the third row, so that is very simple. Now, chain 3 and 3 more double crochet. Excuse me. Oh, my tongue. Oh, I'm so unhappy. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4 double crochet and into the next chain 3 space, make this triangle. So, first, excuse me, second, third, fourth. Then please make chain 2 and back to the same space, and please make another 4 double crochet. Then move to the next chain 3 space and please make 4 double crochet. And chain 2. And 4 double crochet. So there are two triangles here, and here is like a opening space, like this. Then move to the corner, and corner is always same, chain 4 double crochet, chain 5, 4 double crochet, and repeat this side. So after making corner, please move to this chain 3 space and make 4 double crochet, chain 2, 4 double crochet, and without any chain, and move to next space, and 4 double crochet, chain 2, 4 double crochet, and here is corner. So please repeat like that. Okay? Alright, finished the round 5. So please repeat round 4 and round 5 as many rounds as you want if you want to make a big size with one motif. And this is the square pattern that you can enlarge it. And also, if you want to make a small pieces and join as you go, I would like to show you how to do it. My yarn didn't have enough, but if you make a 4, 5, 6, 7 rounds like these, quite beautiful and really nice, or you know, pot holder or vase holder or something really good. So you can give to your friends, or you can use at your home. Alright, so the next step, I would like to show you how to join as you go. Okay, let's join to this, like this. And this is the third round, and I made to the first corner. Then it should be chain 5 space, but please make chain 2 and pick the motif, and from under or long side together, and make a slip stitch tightly and shape it. Then please make chain 2 again. So that is chain 5 and joined like this at the corner. Then please make 4 double crochet as usual. This is a, you know, quite loose joining because there is not so many joining point in this round. This is the third round method, but if you want to crochet at even rounds like 4 round, 4 round, 6 round, 8, there is chain 3 space here, so you can join into chain 5 spaces and chain 3 spaces, chain 3 spaces and chain 3 spaces and chain 5 spaces like this. So it is more comfortable maybe. So this is 1, 2, 3 joining point, and so after making 4 double crochet, move to next point and please make 4 double crochet first. Four. And I tried a chain 3, chain 1 join and chain, and so 3 stitches, it didn't work well. So in this case, I decided to join with the first stitch, so slip stitch like this, and then chain 1. And back to the same space, and then please continue for double crochet again. So it is better than chain or 3 stitches method. If you make chain 1 join and chain 1, you will have larger space here. It doesn't look nice. Okay, so here, and then to the corner, so if you crochet, you know, like a lace slit, bed split, seat slit, size 10, like that, you can make more rounds, and then please join in with other odd rounds. Okay, so here, 1, 2. And then into the chain 5 space, you know, long side together, light side outside. So from so when you pick, please pick from under like this, not from over, from under. Then slip stitch. Slip stitch is it's like a chain, and then chain 2 back to the another the same corner, and then please continue, make 4 double crochet. So join like this. It's pretty, isn't it? So maybe when you are crochet another motif, you can have 1, 2, 3, 4 pointed, you know, star here like this, like a square. So the, you know, the opening space is also beautiful. I insist that this pattern has very beautiful open space. So look at the pattern. The pattern is still beautiful, but look at the opening space. It's very beautiful, isn't it? Like a jewel. So I would like to name this pattern Jewel Granny Square. It's a very beautiful name. So I would like to finish this round. And I like all 3 rounds because it is, you know, outstanding compared to the other rounds. So if you see like this, it's kind of, you know, diamond shape and still very beautiful like this. So if you make a chain here, and so you can hang onto Christmas tree, it's a nice decoration. And or if you change the colors like I did, you can, you know, make the centerpiece pop out like a, you know, even the same stitches, it looks all different. So I like this square opening space shape and stitches, so I like both. And when you finish, usually we make chain 2 and double crochet, but in this case I prefer to finish chain 5 and join, more natural. So that you don't see any ends at the corner, because the corner we make our joining, so you cannot leave the ends, it is hard to hide. So I prefer to fasten up at the 4 double side so you can weave the ends easily. So, and I prefer to fasten up. This is like our iron cloth here. So it's like iron close, and there is, you know, opening like a square, and it's expanding to the corners so that the shape is beautiful. So I can move a little to position it. How was it? It is very beautiful, but yet very easy, and so you can understand how to close it right now. So now you remember how to do it, so you can enjoy with many rounds like these, or you can enjoy mixing colors, or you can enjoy small motifs. So you can enjoy in many ways with this pattern, okay? And then so let's enjoy. All right, thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.